Good morning, class. So today I am going to discuss about the five kingdom classification, part 2. As we discussed in part 1, the five kingdom system, categories of classification, and all the kingdom, kingdom Monera, kingdom Protista, kingdom Fungi, kingdom Plantae, and kingdom Animalia. Now I am going to discuss about the binomial nomenclature. So as you know, binomial nomenclature, as according to name, binomial means two names. In two names, first one is a genus and second one is a species. And you can say this, these are the scientific name or biological name. So in binomial nomenclature, the first part in these names is the genus and the second part is the name of the particular species of genus. For example, Rana tigrina. In this, Rana is a genus and tigrina is a species. Now, major groups of animals. So, the animal kingdom is divided into 9 major phyla. These phylums are number 1, Porifera, phylum number 2, Cnidaria, phylum number 3, Platyhelminthes, phylum number 4, Nematoda, phylum number 5, Annelida, phylum number 6, Arthropoda, phylum number 7, Mollusca, phylum number 8, Echinodermata, and phylum number 9, Chordata. Now we are going to discuss about the phylum Porifera with examples. So main characteristics of phylum Porifera are the pore bears sponges, multicellular, body consists of hollow tube, no single mouth but many pores or canals are present in the body wall. A single large opening on the top is the exit for water. Example of phylum Porifera is cycle and bath sponge. So you can see the picture of cycle. Next phylum is Cnidaria or Coelenterata. So in this phylum, the main characteristics are sac-like animals. Body wall encloses a single cavity in which digestion takes place. Tentacles present to catch food organism. And these are found in water, mostly in sea, very few in fresh water. Example of phylum Cnidaria are Hydra, jellyfish, sea anemone and corals. Next phylum is Platyhelminthes, or you can say flatworms. These are small, soft, flattened, unsegmented worms without a body cavity. The alimentary canal has only one opening. Most of the flatworms are parasite. Example of phylum Platyhelminthes are liver fluke and tapeworm. Next phylum is Nematoda or roundworms. These are long, cylindrical and unsegmented without a body cavity. Alimentary canal opens at two ends, mouth and anus. Mostly parasitic but some live free in soil. Examples of phylum Nematoda are Ascaris and hookworms. Next phylum is Annelida. So, main characteristics of phylum Annelida are segmented or ringed worms, well-developed digestive system with the alimentary canal open at both end with a mouth and anus. They have true body cavity, the coelom. Example of phylum Annelida are earthworms, leeches and nereids. Next phylum is Arthropoda. So main characteristics of arthropodas are jointed legged animals. This phylum has the largest number of species in the animal kingdom. These animals have jointed limbs. There is an exoskeleton made of chitin. Example of phylum arthropodas are crayfish, crabs, millipede and centipede. Phylum Mollusca. soft, unsegmented body, hard, calcareous shells to protect the soft body. They have a muscular foot to help locomotion and also act as a weapon in some cases. Example of phylum Mollusca, snail, slug, oyster and octopus. You can see these examples in the given pictures. Next phylum is Echinodermata. Main characteristics of these phylums are unsegmented marine animals. They have an exoskeleton and a spiny surface, radially symmetrical. They move by means of two feet. Examples of these phylum: starfish, sea urchin, sea cucumber, and brittle star. Then, last phylum is Chordata. Notochord or vertebral column are present. Vertebral column are also known as backbone. Heart on ventral side and nerve cord on dorsal side. Hemoglobin contained in RBC. Examples of phylum Chordata are fishes, frogs, lizards, birds, and hairy quadrupeds.